We're back at 7:43 with Oscar winner Robert De Niro at the center of a new firestorm over vaccines.
He made some controversial claims to us here on Today on Wednesday. NBC's Joe Fryer has the fallout from that. Joe, good morning.
Willie, Savannah, good morning. In that candid interview on Today, Robert De Niro said he's not anti-vaccine, but he did raise a number of questions about the link between vaccines and autism, a connection that has been widely discredited. This morning, we want to take a closer look at some of De Niro's comments, answering questions many parents might have.
I'm not anti-vaccine. I want safe vaccines.
Robert De Niro may have pulled the controversial documentary Vaxxed from the Tribeca Film Festival, but the award-winning actor still has questions.
How the vaccines are dangerous, if not given, dangerous to certain people who are more susceptible. And nobody seems to want to address that.
The medical community says research has addressed that question, and vaccines don't cause autism in any population.
What we know is that there are certain children who are susceptible to autism, and those children are children who are born prematurely, whose parents are older.
De Niro is not convinced.
There is a link, and they're saying there isn't, but there's certain things. There's the obvious one is thimerosal, which is mercury-based preservative.
But the Centers for Disease Control says reputable scientific studies have shown that mercury in vaccines given to young children is not a cause of autism. And since 2001, childhood vaccines have been thimerosal-free. For De Niro, this issue is personal. His 18-year-old son has autism.
Because there are many people who will come out and say, no, I saw my kid change like overnight. Mm-hmm. I saw what happened, and I should have done something, and I didn't.
Is that the experience you had, Robert? Something changed overnight?
My wife says that. I don't remember.
Pediatrician Ari Brown says she's had this conversation with families, some of whom eventually realized the change was not overnight.
A lot of times, it's not seeing the signs until it becomes increasingly apparent when the child is a toddler.
Still, many parents echo De Niro's fears about vaccines. Some have asked their doctors to delay or stagger those shots, thinking that will reduce the risk. So does it?
There are studies that show that children who receive vaccinations on time versus those that don't, for whatever reason, have exactly the same developmental outcomes.
The medical community says when vaccination rates drop, it opens the door for disease outbreaks like measles and whooping cough, something De Niro questions after watching the documentary.
I don't know if those statistics are accurate.
But doctors note that in 2000, measles had been eliminated in the U.S., yet in 2014, there were 667 cases, and in 2015, 189 cases. The CDC says the majority of patients were unvaccinated.
Some parents also wonder if the MMR shot, measles, mumps, and rubella, can be separated into three different shots. But Dr. Brown says in the U.S., the vaccine for just measles is not available. You do have to get the MMR shot. And when it comes to autism rates, at least one study found no difference between those who get the single measles vaccine versus the MMR shot. Willie and Savannah.
All right, Joe Fryer, thank you very much. Savannah, I think you and I both were a little surprised by how far Robert De Niro wanted to go yesterday. He obviously came ready to speak about this issue.
He was very, very passionate. Obviously, it's something that's personal to him because he does have a son who is autistic. But, you know, there are a lot of questions and there's a lot of study that's been out there. And so I think, you know, we wanted to be sure to include all of that information and people can learn more about that for themselves.
As we said, the scientific community has been pretty conclusive that there's no link, but a lot of people still looking for answers with their own children. Mm-hmm.